My guide is an old friend. He's called Aaron Hagar. He's the perfect avatar of this whole town. He's a customizer, a painter, a Renaissance man of diverse taste. But right now, he's late picking me up at the airport. Ah, that must be him.
Look at that! Oh, how cool is that, buddy? Can I get in the back? Let me just throw my bag in.
Nice to see you. How was your flight?
Oh, it was fantastic.
Good. Welcome to Reno, Tahoe.
Reno, Tahoe!
Brought you some water.
Give me a man hug.
How are you, Aaron?
Nice to see you,
Great
man.
To see you, buddy.
Here's some water for you.
Right.
We'll head up the hill?
Yeah, let's go for it.
Straight away, I know I'm in for an interesting time. What on earth is a surf wagon doing 200 miles from the nearest coastline? Like most people in Tahoe, Aaron moved here from somewhere else. In his case, Southern California, and bought a bit of that lifestyle here.
So you picked me up in this from the airport, and I absolutely love it. 56?
This is a 1956 Chevy 210 wagon. It's a good driver. You know, it's not a real fancy car. This is about as clean as I like them.
I like it. I don't really have to worry.
It drives nice.
Drives nice.
I mean, look, it's a one finger.
Yeah, it's a cruiser.
It's not even a one hander. It's a one finger.
It's lovely, and I love the fact that it's a wagon. There's plenty of space in it.
Yeah, family car.
So this is your shop?
This is it, my man.
Oh, I can't wait. Look at the cars already. Huh?
I normally don't like them this pretty because they're too hard to take care of, but this is a 1929 Model A pickup. It actually belongs to my friend, Dan, and he's always wanted one, and he had nowhere to put it, so I said, you can keep it in the shop. We're working on some stuff in there, so I put it out here for a couple of days, but she runs and drives pretty much all original.
Beautiful. American history right there. Come on, get me inside. I want to see the shop.
All right, you ready?
I'm ready.
Ready?
Ready.
All right, here we go.
Aaron's garage is everything I imagined, a tribute to a man of many interests. Where else would you see a Triumph cheek my jowl with a rap rod and an entire horn section?
As you see, I love character and things that make you smile. This one smiles on its own.
I'm gonna get to Red Voodoo in a minute, but I just want to, again, you know, you love your British cars,
do
you?
At heart, I have a couple old Land Rovers,
too. Can we have a look under it?
Absolutely. So this is what makes this an outlaw. We've got a 64
That's out of a Mustang
200 CID with about 200 horsepower in a car that weighs, what, about 1650?
I bet it sounds like a V8,
though. Oh, it
although
sounds.
It's a straight six.
I worked on this exhaust for months trying to get the right sound out of it, and it sounds beautiful.
See, I just love that. You take an old car and you hot rod it with a different size motor, you change the suspension, change the appearance. The outlaw culture is so important, and the cars are looking so beautiful that car manufacturers themselves are going to start to emulate that in modern design
coming up. So, and unlike rat rods, which tend to be jalopies, and you know, they tend to be used parts, they tend to be a little less safe by reputation. The outlaw culture, I think, has been the opposite. It's more about craftsmanship and high end finishes and machine work and really precision.
Aaron's lately been heavily influenced by the Porsche outlaw scene, but I think his heart will always be with the hot rods and rat rods of his youth.
October Moon, let's go to this one first, save the best till last.
Yes.
See, in my eyes, when you said about the outlaw culture being more precise, this is more sort of a steampunk culture.
Yes,
this
totally.
Is, if you find something laying on the side of the road and you can tack weld it to a car, well, then just do it. I mean, it's evident here, isn't it?
And this is about repurposing. So this is a really good example.
When, like an orchestra,
exactly.
Like a band.
But when you can repurpose something that moved air in the opposite direction and repurpose it to take in air, right? I think that is kind of the epitome of that scene. You know what I mean?
I love that.
It's fun. It takes, you know, I don't have to match CFM because it's not a drag car, but it runs well and it drives well. And
It's kind of hurts your head.
It's quirky.
It hurts your head. It's kind of...
It hurts your head when you get in it.
It's very, dare I say, and I love this. This is amazing. It's very Dr. Seuss.
Totally, yeah.
Yes.
Very Seussian.
Yes, Seussian is the word. It is. Let's move on to the piece of the resistance, right? Which is, I think it's fair to say, staring at it from here, it's an assault on the eyes. This was built in... the parking lot of a casino under a tarpaulin.
Under a tarp on a friend's trailer.
That's incredible.
With mostly free parts. I did buy the shell and the frame from a group of locals. Supposedly, this was the first commercial tow truck in Reno. It was in a field, and I picked it up as an abandoned project and went to work on it.
Red Voodoo's made Aaron's name in the car scene when it was unveiled in 2005, and the quality of the build helped him gain respectability.
There's something amazing about every single piece of it. Can I have a look inside?
Absolutely. I would encourage it.
Oh, look, before I do that, look at this. Look.
They do spin under air pressure.
They spin. It's machine
gun. And what's fun is when they're hot, I throw a little WD-40 in there because, you know, you have to loop the bearings, and it'll smolder for a few minutes.
Oh, fantastic.
The kids just go
fantastic.
Wild, you know?
Oh, look at the interior. That is...
So this is chopped. This is a 6-inch chop and channel. So what happens is you lose some of the floor. So this one's a little tight.
You need to be a very small person to be able to drive
that. You can. You have a little more room in the passenger side, but yeah.
There's a lot of people out there in the world that don't understand these kind of cars, but I just absolutely love it.
Aaron's ability to reuse, repurpose, and reshape all sorts of metal, always filtered through his own offbeat sensibilities, shows that he's maintained the adaptability you need to live off the beaten path. I'm hoping he can apply those skills towards finding some good food.
So we got a little surprise for you
here. This is fantastic.
Some of our local classics.
Lovely.
As well as some of our local characters. Attaboys.
Attaboys. They're all excited to see you, aren't they? Huh?
Now, I warn you, we grow them big here.
I can see that. And you grow them small as well.
I'm excited to meet Aaron's friends and tuck into some lunch, but I can't take my eyes off the cars. Have you ever seen a Ferrari parked next to a Gasser? Or a Sunbeam Tiger next to a Rat Rod? Aaron tells me his friends are like him. They're all transplants to Tahoe. And now, despite the fact that they're all into very different sorts of cars, they've created a unique little culture here.
And my friend Ken.
Ken from Denmark. Nice to meet you, Ken.
Is that yours?
Yeah, half of it. The rest is the bank's.
Very good.
Are you ready for some Hungry Bears?
Yes, sir.
What's the dish that the locals like to eat?
Oh, it's our barbecue. Barbecue, chicken and ribs.
Barbecue, chicken and ribs. Tell me what's going on in your brain. What made you do this?
It's a local truck. It's a 1935. It was a 35 dump truck.
Yeah, I was going to say
really?
A dump truck. Huh?
Yeah.
I love the bomber-style seats and the doors.
Yeah, those are all hand-built.
Beautiful work.
Every rivet in this truck has been hand-pounded.
Surely your wife is missing a couple of saucepans from the kitchen.
Those are old ones. As I grew, the saucepans got bigger. So,
salad
again, I repurposed the old stuff to put it on here.
I can see that. Well, tell us about this car.
It's a 64 Fairlane Gasser. Has a big block Chevy in it, a Chrysler Liberty Modified Hemi box in it.
Oh, yes! Whoa!
That's what it sounds like.
So, Nick, what do you do for a living?
I own an auto repair shop.
Of course you do. Of course you do.
Down the street.
Oh, lads! Food's up!
Lunchtime!
Come on, let's grab some food.
Let me take that off. Beautiful.
That's great.
There it is.
Yes.
Tahoe strikes me as a sort of small-town melting pot. In LA, the op-rod guys would be here. The sports guys would be over there. The truck guys would be somewhere else. You don't have that here. Everyone gets together and rubs elbows in cars that don't seem like they should be on the same planet. Even share space at the drive-in. I've never seen anything like it.
Right, Ken, come on, let's go and have a look at your little dandy red Ferrari.
Your dream car, my friend.
My dream car.
Your dream car.
Now, I'm going to tell you right from the off.
Yep.
I am, like, a super fan of a very decent Ferrari. Dare I say, if anyone pictures a Ferrari, anyone, you picture it in a Rosso red with a tan leather interior, and that is just epic. Tell me about the truck. What you got, a small block?
Yeah.
A 350?
Yeah, but you pump them out a little bit.
So you've, you know what you got horsepower-wise, or?
You know, we really don't talk about that kind
you don't.
Of stuff.
Okay. You know? obviously a filthy word to talk about horsepower. Ron, I can't tell you how much I appreciate you bringing your vehicle down and showing us. And me and Aaron have had a great time. But, you know, the one thing that's bugging me about all these vehicles, where do you find them? Where do you get these vehicles?
Well, that's funny. You know, we're close to Nevada here, so you know you can go out here. There's a mine out in Dayton here. And you just cruise the back streets, right? And you see a piece out there. This was sitting in the bushes.
No way.
You just stop.
Stop, go talk to the owner.
I go, hey, you want to sell that car?
Here's a case of beer.
Sure.
And $100.